In this video, we demonstrate the assembly and operation of an AirBoss Chem Bio isopod. Patient transportation isolation devices are not pieces of equipment we use on a regular basis. Familiarization with the correct assembly and operation techniques of such devices ensures patient and healthcare professional safety when called into use. Other versions of this isolation device are manufactured by this company. A large proportion of this video is also applicable to those devices. Careful assembly of the Chem Bio isopod is warranted to ensure proper function of the device. Beginning with the enclosure open, assemble the ribs by connecting the rib buckles. Insert the spine segments into the receptacle on each rib buckle. Remove the two exterior filter port plugs on the head end of the enclosure. Then install a HEPA filter into each port. At the foot end of the enclosure, remove filter port plugs from the interior ports. Recheck each port for the gasket before installing the filter. Then install both HEPA OVAG filters, being careful to not over-tighten the filter. Remove the exterior filter port plugs at the foot end of the enclosure. Ensure each port has a gasket. Install the breathing hoses with two male fittings into the ports labeled blower, so that the unattached ends of the hoses have the openings facing each other. Thread the unattached tube ends into the three-way valve. Hand tighten all the fittings. Thread the female end of the remaining breathing hose onto the top of the three-way valve. Ensure the side ports on the blower motor have gaskets and a threaded plug installed. Remove the filter port plug on the top of the blower motor and ensure the gasket is present and intact. Finally, thread the unattached male end of the breathing hose into the top of the blower motor and hand tighten. Place the blower motor into the pouch with the male exhaust port facing down. Secure hoses to the enclosure with the hook and loop straps. At this point, you will need to turn the enclosure on its side to insert the black support plate. The pocket for the support plate is the smaller of two pockets located on the head end of the enclosure. Insert the support plate and secure with the hook and loop closure. If a spine board is to be used during transport, it will be inserted into the remaining pocket at this point. During patient transport, first responders and healthcare professionals should have donned the level of personal protective equipment necessary to minimize exposure to chemical or biological contamination. Once the patient is in the isopod, if possible, you should secure the enclosure to the transport device using the 8 straps provided. For proper airflow, ensure the three-way valve is fully open at the 12 o'clock position prior to use. Snorkel ports are used to manage lines and tubing necessary to support the patient. Oxygen tubing, IV lines, ventilator tubing, etc. should be placed into the enclosure before the patient is loaded and fed through the snorkel port to the exterior. The hook and loop straps should then be wrapped tightly around the snorkel port to secure the lines in place. You should consider adding tape around the lines to further secure them. Ideally, all items anticipated for providing care would be placed in the unit before the patient is loaded. Consider developing a checklist to include items such as medications, suction equipment, IV lines, emesis bags, spill kits, etc., to aid in identifying what you might need. En route, however, first responders or healthcare providers may need to add medications or other patient care items to the isopod environment. Pass-through ports were designed for this purpose. The pass-through port is located at the head of the enclosure. To access the port, the user must grasp the internal plastic sleeve using the glove port closest to the head of the bed. The user will close off the plastic sleeve and remove the exterior pass-through cap and filter. Items can then be placed into the plastic sleeve and the cap and filter replaced. At this point, the interior plastic sleeve can be released and the items can be retrieved using the same glove port. The vertical drop bag is used for introducing clean, larger items into the enclosure. The bag has one zipper on the outside and one on the inside that opens into the interior of the unit. Before placing an item into the bag, be sure the interior zipper is closed. Place the item in the bag via the outside zipper and close when done. Using the glove port closest to the bag, open the interior zipper. Remove the item from the bag and close the zipper. A hot swap is performed in the event that first responders or healthcare providers experience chemical breakthrough, a filter becomes soiled or damaged, or the patient finds it difficult to breathe. If such a procedure is performed, users must be in the appropriate level of PPE for the chemical or pathogen to mitigate exposure risk. During the swap, the internal HEPA OVAG filters necessitating the exchange must be isolated using the three-way valve to prevent unfiltered air and contaminants from entering the user space via the filter port. Turn the valve to the desired position to isolate the filter to be changed. Position 2 at 3 o'clock for a left filter swap. Position 3 at 9 o'clock for a right filter swap. Open the new filter and introduce it into the enclosure using the vertical drop bag as previously described. Remove the old filter using the closest glove port. Replace with the new filter. Manage the old filter as waste per your organization's policy and protocol. You should be aware that contaminant may be in the breathing hose after the filter is swapped and the three-way valve is returned to its original 12 o'clock position to operate from both filters.